Hi everyone, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Today, I want to do a side-by-side visual comparison between a mirrorless camera and the king of one-shot camera, Ricoh Theta Z1 right here. So Ricoh Theta Z1 just announced a 2021 version with a bigger storage, 51GB to be precise. I will have the new camera on hand to do an in-depth review in May. But most of the old school 360 photographers, including myself, still think DSLR or mirrorless camera with a full frame sensor will be way better in image quality, color representation, noise control, and sharpness. Well, the real question is how much better? I think there are a lot of biases on this topic. So far, there is no fair comparison put these two approach side by side. All you see at best is putting Theta Z1 regular photo against DSLR. That is not fair as Z1 True Power is using dual fisheye plugins with auto merge HDR. Or you see people use crop sensor DSLR without HDR or flash technique, which is also a bad example. Today, I put Sony Alpha 1, the best mirrorless camera just released in 2021, against the Theta Z1 with dual fisheye plugin. I also show you just the regular Z1 DNG photo, so you have a good reference. This is an 8K 260 video, so make sure to set your video in 8K. The best result will be seeing it in an actual virtual tour. So I also provided a link to see the comparison in a real virtual tour and a side-by-side comparison view. This view is unheard of even in the virtual tour industry. So definitely go check those out first. Okay, assuming you are back, let's talk about it. The first one is shot on Sony Alpha 1 with this rig. It takes 4 shots in 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree, and 270 degrees, each degree with 9 bracketed HDR photo. So total 36 photos merged together to create this stunning panel. Sorry, my house is a mess, but let's focus on the image quality instead of my messy house. Next, we have Ricoh Theta Z1 in dual fisheye mode, shooting 9 bracketed HDR photo. The full tutorial on how to do this is right here. As you see on regular, not zoomable virtual tour mode, you can't really say Sony Alpha 1 is better than Z1. The Z1 has more HDR artifacts and more saturated color, but 90% of the people seeing this on a virtual tour website, MLS, or Facebook 360 wouldn't be able to tell the quality differences. The only time you can tell the differences is when you zoom in. Assuming your virtual tour software has a zoomable feature and does not compress your uploaded virtual tour photos. Here is a close-up 200% zoom-in comparison. You can tell Sony Alpha 1 has a lot more details compared to Z1. It is also sharper and has a more natural color. I have to say most people wouldn't get this quality of 360 photos with their DSLR without the workflow I explain in detail in the next tutorial. And I can even get better result with the fresh technique that Z1 wouldn't be able to do at all. Let's take a look at Theta Z1 regular DNG photo. That is pretty bad. So never use Theta Z1 regular photo mode for professional virtual tour. You wouldn't be able to control the highlight and the shadow. So your window will be blown out and your shadow will be black. Learn how to use dual fisheye plugin following this tutorial. It is free if you have Theta Z1, so no excuse not to do so. After seeing the result, What do you think? Comment below. Are you going to stick to Theta Z1 or learn MiaLet's KMI workflow? If you are ready to make big money, make your work stand out from 99% of the virtual tour photographers out there, you need to smash the subscribe button and the notification bell to watch our next tutorial series, Virtual Tour Masterclass. Shoot professional virtual tour with Sony Alpha 1 and PT GUI 12. Sony Alpha 1 right here is the best 2D photo camera in 2021, and it is even better when you use it for virtual tour creation. It shoots faster bracketed HDR, giving you 200 plus megapixel super high resolution 360 photo with only 4 angles, no Nadia or Zenit shot necessary. If you look up and down of my 360 photos right here, you see a full immersive 360 photo without a tripod or a panel head. That is with only 4 quick shots, and I have a workflow that only requires front and back 2 shots. With my new HDR workflow, you will create faster 360 photo than Theta Z1 or Instax 360 X2 using the brand new PT GUI 12. And we will deep dive into 3D Vista and Teleport Me for a super high quality virtual tour hosting, so you can use the full megapixel of your powerful Sony Alpha 1. We will tell you which lens and panel head to use to save you money and how easy to set it up to have a faster shooting time than Theta Z1. Yes, faster. The best thing is, this series is 100% free on Creator Up YouTube channel. No paywall, so all the real professionals can judge how good my content is. I'm here to help the industry to grow instead of profiting from someone who wants to learn. So, if you want to master your virtual tool skill and land commercial clients like I do, come join me in the next tutorial. Ciao for now.